Greetings, everyone. Hope all of you are having an absolutely fantastic day. We are back with more Pathfinder content, and this time, Owlcat has released a small patch for the current beta release. Nothing too game-changing, but there are definitely some nice quality of life fixes that I appreciate, and I know a lot of the people who have been commenting on my videos are going to appreciate them as well. So let's go through a few of them. I'll leave a link down below in the description where you can access the full patch notes and you can read through them yourself. So first up, if you are supposed to be able to meet the queen in the war camp, you are now able to do so. Before, even if you received a message to go meet her, she was nowhere in the war camp. Super frustrating. I went back and forth, loaded multiple times trying to find her because I actually love the dialogue that you have with her in that conversation and couldn't do it. So glad definitely that this has been fixed. There was also an issue where during the siege of Dresden, you could not commence the assault on the final gates. That has been fixed. My experience actually is that it was more than just the final gates. I had an issue with the first set of gates as well, where it would not allow me to finish the assault against them. So glad that it's been fixed. I know there are some other people who said they flat out couldn't finish the Dresden mission because of this issue as well. There is a way around it, but it requires you to basically go through the entire map, killing all of the enemies instead of trying to make a beeline towards the gates. And I think maybe everybody is not aware of the workaround, so it's just stopping some people's progress. So good that this has been resolved. The game would sometimes freeze in turn-based mode. This has been fixed. I definitely experienced that, and it's part of the reason I started switching back to real time. And now with that fixed, I love being able to just switch back and forth between turn-based and real time mode. I think that's one of the real strengths of this game. And then in the Crusade, some units couldn't move in the Crusade tactical battles or they got stuck. Definitely experienced this multiple times. It was the biggest issue for me with the Hell Knights, because with the recent upgrade, they gave Hell Knights horses sometimes during these battles. And for whatever reason, if you went a certain amount of squares with those horses, the Hell Knight would just stop. It wouldn't allow you to attack or do anything else, and you basically had to reload the battle. Crazy annoying, especially since the Hell Knights look really, really cool on the horses, and it added another dynamic to those Crusade battles. So it was frustrating to see that end up being a negative when you were actually using them. Glad that that's been fixed. I don't see a fix for the issue I talked about before where I took Dresden but then could not hire any more units and was unable to build, but that doesn't necessarily mean it hasn't been fixed. I haven't had another playthrough where I've went past Dresden before. So if you have and you're able to recruit units the way you would expect to, leave me a comment down below and let me know. That's definitely something I would like to be aware of. And then finally, there are two bigger issues, at least for me, that have been fixed with this update. So first, after loading a save, abilities would disappear from the quick bar. That has been fixed. So annoying. Especially if you were a sorcerer or a wizard or some sort of spell casting class. Of course, you want to have all those spells in your hotbars. You don't want to have to dig through the menus every time you want to use something. And a lot of times you'll forget you have something if it's not sitting there on the hotbar. So to have to go back in and put everything back on the hotbar after every single load, especially if you loaded in the middle of a playthrough, super frustrating. So definitely glad that that has been fixed. And then finally, I don't see it in the list of patch notes here, but the issue that I and multiple other people have been having, where if you respect your character, all the mythic levels could not be selected, that has now been fixed. So I can respect my characters the way I usually would expect to, which is going to make my build video significantly better. I've hated having to use those screenshots. So definitely appreciate that. Like I said, I'll leave a link down below with the full list. Nothing like truly game shattering or game breaking, but nice quality of life fixes that I'm sure we all appreciate. And it's good to see the work continuing to make this game the absolute best that it can be upon launch. I really appreciate the work that they're doing and definitely can't wait to get the full version of this game. Anyway, leave me a comment down below if you have any feedback and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I will see you all in the next video. Take care.